1953, I was commissioned.
And you've mentioned something about NDA. NDA had started by then?
Yes, NDA started in 49.
It was formally started a little later, that 54 or something.
That is when they shifted from Dehradun to Pune.
Yes, so you were in Dehradun then?
I was in Dehradun.
I get the sense that you were the transition period between the old Royal Indian Air Force and the Indian Air Force.
Very much so.
Yes, that's a very interesting phase, and very little has been written about it. Does Dehradun also have an airfield and things like that? No. So where did you do your initial flying?
I did my flying in Begumpet to start with, and then followed up at Hakimpet for the conversion to fighters. We flew the Spitfire 18.
So what was the first aircraft that you flew?
Tiger Moth. Interestingly, perhaps, I also did the last Air Force sortie on the Tiger Moth. We ferried 4 Tiger Moths as a gift to Delhi Flying Club from Tambaram. And I was the last to arrive.
And so if your initial training was in the Tiger Moth, I'm presuming that it was a good enough plane for a trainee pilot?
Oh, it was a beautiful plane.
Yeah.
Pilot sat in the rear.
Okay. Right. Yeah. And how does the Tiger Moth behave in the air in terms of aircraft?
Oh, it's a very sweet aircraft.
Okay.
You couldn't do very high speeds on it. 70 miles per hour was its happy speed.
Okay.
And there have been cases with me where going against the wind, I could see cars overtake on the road. You could do all the aerobatics with it.
Yeah. And then I think you went to Hakimpet, right? After that?
Yeah.
And you had some...
First solo
and the landing, something with the Spitfire you mentioned. What exactly happened?
What happened is, I presume, 2 or 3 instructors who had all flown with me earlier in life were discussing various pupils of the course and their abilities. And perhaps a wager came up that anyone having the guts to straight away send somebody solo. And my instructor said, he also was the flight commander, said, yes, you can send him. He's got 1 sortie left, but if you want, he can go. My name was entered as first solo. Mentally, I was, surprised a little.
Yes.
I had not mentally prepared myself for flying at that moment. But principal says that you're ready to fly.
Yes.
I was launched off and I did the pattern that was brief and came back. And the pattern included 1 circuit of the airfield as if I'm landing, make a proper landing approach. But before landing, go around again and try a second time. So I did that, and on the finals worked out so well that I forgot that I was supposed to go around.
Okay.
So I went ahead and I flared out to land, and I was surprised. Actually, I was supposed to go around so that I learned from that surprise.
Yes.
What happens in the Spitfire, you have 12 feet front nose.
Yes.
And the runway disappears. So you've got 2 small pieces of ground visible to you on 2 sides that you can see through the corner of your eyes.
Oh.
But you can't see the runway ahead right till then. So as I flared out, I was surprised that the runway disappeared. This did not happen in the training aircraft, Spitfire 9. Because Spitfire 9, you are slightly in front. You are sitting in front.
So you could still see the runway.
Spitfire 18, single-seater, had the seat placed back. So the wings covered it. So when it disappeared, unconsciously, I ballooned and went up. And when I realized that I have ballooned, I opened the throttle, but because of a little uncertainty, I opened it too fast. And the engine didn't pick up, it had a flat spot. So I stalled, and the aircraft started falling. I realized that, so I just held the stick and allowed the aircraft to drop. But it dropped the wing, and that tire, because of the drop, burst. And the aircraft bounced up, and because of dropping on one wheel, started rolling to the left. And I was about to smash on the runway. Just short of getting down, the engine picked up. And the engine was very powerful, so it just dragged me off the ground, and I was back in the air. Now that I was back in the air, I got my senses back, and I did another circuit. I forgot to close my canopy after going out, because we were supposed to do the circuit and landing with the canopy open. So the noise level was very high and my excitement was very high. So in the background noise, I did not hear what was being told to. Don Michael was on the instructor's side. He was controlling and saying, don't worry, do the circuit simply. You're doing very well. Make another approach and land. So I made another approach. Nobody knew that my tire had burst. Then I landed, but because the tire was not there on the right side, the aircraft touched on the hub and started dragging. Fortunately, my touchdown was extremely good. So there was enough braking available to me to keep the aircraft on the runway. And because of this high drag of one side, the aircraft stopped in 300-400 yards. Then I saw the crash vehicles and lots of people coming to me in a truck. So it was a eventful day.
After you finished solo on the Spitfire, what was the next aircraft?
I was posted to a Vampire Scout, number one.
Yeah.